Right, Aki Kareem here for BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined by former world champion Ricky the Hitman Hatton. Ricky, thank you so much for joining me today. It's
pleasure,
a big,
mate.
Big fight week, particularly for your family. Young Campbell makes his fourth professional fight on Saturday.
Yeah, very exciting time for the family. Yeah, he's got another four rounder and another journeyman. He's from Uruguay, based in Spain. We won two, lost four. So, but I mean, they're all the same run of the mill, aren't they, at this stage of your career? But maybe a different style, you know, that is had used to in the past. But I think it's all about just building his confidence up, you know what I mean? He's fighting on a regular basis. He's making improvements each time he steps in the ring. We've always said it's going to be a slow progress. But the main thing is, for myself and Matthew, we're seeing, you know, improvements every time. And I'm happy for him to stay at the same level for a bit while he's just improving the way he is. You know, he's building up his confidence. He's building up his following. And, what a build. What a bill for him to go on, 20 years of age, you know, on Joshua Carter up at their Tottenham there. Incredible. He's getting all the top shows, and I couldn't be any more grateful.
Yeah, I mean, Ricky, it's such a big card for him to be on. And, you know, he's dealing with the nerves and everything so well. But, you know, this is a massive, massive stage. So what advice are you going to give him to actually dealing with the nerves on a fight night like this?
Well, to be honest with you, his debut was on a big stage. And I think the debut was always going to be the hardest one, because a big thing, you know, was made of Ricky Hatton's son making his professional debut. And he was on Good Morning Britain, and he was having documentaries done on him. And he's never, in fairness, done an interview before in his life up to that point. And I think it all just got to him. But, I mean, that standing him in good stead. He got the toughest one out of the way. Then he went to the Manchester Arena. You know, and he's fighting on all the big shows, and it doesn't come any bigger than this. So, I mean, I'm not saying, thrown in at the deep end isn't the word, what I mean, but I mean, because every show has been a big one that he started on. I think he's just taking it in his stride now. I mean, he's sort of like been one big show after the other, so he doesn't know any different, really, because he's been every show he's been on, has been massive. So he's handling with it well. And I always said to Campbell, I said, if you want to get to the top like all these people on the bills that you're fighting on, you know, the sooner you get used to this, the better. And it was very, very similar for me. I mean, I boxed at leisure centres on the small old shows, but I was at Madison Square Garden, and I boxed at Atlantic City, and then I boxed at the, you know, Manchester Arena on big bills. But and it's standing me in good stead for my future, and it'll do the same for Campbell, I think.
Yeah, I actually caught up with Campbell the other day, and he said that he's doing a lot of really good work in the gym. He's not quite showed it on fight night yet, was his exact words. You know, that's quite a hard process, isn't it, as well, to transfer what you're doing in the gym onto fight night. How do you think he's going to bridge that gap as well, and what sort of tips could you give him on that side of things?
It just gives time. I mean, to be honest, some of the things I was doing in the gym with Billy Graham on the body belt, you know what I mean? Like, you know, we worked on that, on my body punching for years, you know, changing the angle to get the pit of the stomach and stuff like that. And I could get it on the body belt, but I couldn't get it in my spars. And then all of a sudden, you know, I started getting it more and more in my spars, but I couldn't transfer it to the fight. And then all of a sudden, one fighter just turned up, I think, against Tommy Peacock, and it all just come off. And that's the same with Campbell. I mean, the advice I give Campbell, I mean, obviously he's getting it in the gym from Matthew, and he gets it from me. It's just, I feel, his last fight, he showed great head movement. You know, he showed a better left jab. But he's got that Hatton traits in him. Sometimes he can't help but get his foot down. And then I think in the last two rounds, he still did well, but he smothered his work a little bit, forgot the jab a little bit. And I just turned around and said, listen, Campbell, you know, your work rate is always going to be 100 mile an hour like mine was. But I said, if you just knock it down 10 mile an hour, throw a few less punches, but look where you're placing the punches. I said, you'll have more success. And I said, and that's what I did. You know what I mean? I just stopped the gap, you know, just stopped trying to bulldoze everyone. You know what I mean? And I didn't get caught as much. And I was finding the target a lot easier. But sometimes, you know, I think you'll be better when he goes to six rounds, Aki. I mean, I'm happy for him to be on the four rounds, and I think, just speak for Matthew, I'm happy for him to go on the four rounds, you know, at the minute. But I think when he knows he's got an extra two rounds and he has to pace himself that little bit more, I think we'll see better quality from him. No, we're not seeing better quality from him at the minute. I just think the longer distance will suit him. I think he's like in the amateurs, isn't it? You know, you're thinking, I've only got three rounds, I've got to put my foot down. And he's probably thinking the same, it's only four rounds, I've got to put my foot down. And I think once he does more rounds and he knows he has to pace it a little bit, I think we'll see a bit better quality from him.
Yeah, no, that's an interesting point there. And, you know, there's still a lot of support out there for the Hatton family. That Cribs we did, I mean, the reaction to it, 500,000 views and all positive comments, it does show that your legacy in the game as well, yourself and Matthew, that, you know, from that having that legacy, it's really standing in me a good stead because the fans are just so keen to see another Hatton doing well.
Yeah, it's positive. Even for his first fight, which, you know, he built up a lot of nervous energy and, you know, stuff like that. And I had a little bit of a, I mean, I'm not asked, but because it is what it is, but I had a little bit of a sneaky feeling. I thought he might cut for a bit of stick here. And he didn't. Everything was really, really positive. And I can't thank people enough. I mean, you're always going to get the odd dickhead, aren't you, that says this, this and that. But the massive, massive high percentage of people is all complimentary. Do you know what I mean? Getting behind him, supporting him and that. And, you know, at the end of the day, if you love me because of, you know, my fighting style and the type of person I am and what I stand for and my morals and you know, and just a Jack the Lad, you know, feet on the ground, you know, one of them type, you know, you can't help but not love Campbell because he's exactly the same. He's, you know, and I'm not blowing his own trumpet because, you know, he can't kid the public. And I think they can see that he's just a chip off the old block. He's like me. And I think that's why the support is all positive. And it doesn't matter, you know, how many, you know, boxing experts or how many of us think we're boxing experts. You know, it's not rocket science, is it? He's only young. He only had a handful of amateur fights. Give him time. And I think the high majority of the general public see that. And that's why it's all been positive. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Definitely. So that's Campbell Hatton, of course, making his fourth professional fight on Saturday night. And I believe he's got a good slot on the card as well. So tune in for that. And of course, the main event, Ricky, it's, you know what? I've been speaking to so many boxing people over the weekend. It's really split the boxing fans. Half are going with Joshua, half are going with Usyk. I mean, do you see it like that? Do you see it as such a close 50-50 fight like that?
I think I do. I think slightly edge to AJ. But yeah, 50-50. I mean, to be honest with you, whatever way the result goes, I don't think anyone could go, well, that's a shocker. Because I think, you know, they can both, needless to say, AJ's a lot bigger man. But Usyk can certainly hit. And I think it's more of a 50-50 fight now. But since AJ got beat to Ruiz, isn't it? You know, where we can see the vulnerability, you know, of AJ. But, you know, when they say that some defeats, you know, can break you or make you, oh my God, did that make AJ? You know what I mean? He's actually, he started thinking about what he's doing in his last couple of fights. Not that, I mean, because we all loved him for when he, you know, so many explosive knockouts, and he's so excited to watch. But I think he just went a little bit back to basics. I think he dropped it down a little bit, 10 mile an hour, started thinking about where he was placing the punches and just a little bit more cautious, you know, and I think we'd all forgot just how good a boxer he was. I mean, in one way, you don't get an Olympic gold, do you, for not having a fantastic boxing brain and fantastic ability. We all remember him for the great knockouts. But I think he just showed what a clever fighter he has been in his last two fights. And he seems to have slimmed down a little bit for this fight. You know, he's obviously going to be, you know, still the bigger man, but he seems to me like he's slimmed down a little bit. And I think Usyk in his last couple of fights, as he's put the weight on to move into the you know, the heavyweight division, I think he's looked a bit slow. I don't think he's got the you know, as quick as he certainly was at cruiserweight. And I think that might be the reason why AJ's slimmed down a little bit. So AJ gets that little bit of a speed advantage over him. But It's a real tough one. I'm dead excited. I'm really looking forward to it, to be honest with you. But it's, I think I give AJ the edge, but only by that much. Do you know what I mean? It's such a massive fight.
Do you think with two high caliber athletes like this, both very well schooled boxers, particularly Usyk with his style. Do you think we're going to see it at knockout, or do you think it might be cagey and go to points this time around?
I think it might be cagey. Listen, Usyk is very well, very capable of outboxing AJ. You know what I mean? He's a fantastic boxer. But like I mentioned earlier, last few fights reminded us just how good a boxer AJ is. I've got a feeling it might be a bit of a chess match, because I don't think Usyk will want to go for the knockout, because look at the size of the man he's got in front of him. I think Usyk will think, I've got to be clever with this one. I don't want to, you know, cop for a big one. And I think AJ, as I'm repeating myself a little bit, I think AJ's been a little bit more sensible now and a little bit more cautious. I don't think he's going to go out all good blazing for the knockout. So I think it will be a chess match, because Usyk should be worried about AJ's size and power. And AJ will still have that Ruiz fight at the back of his mind. So he's got to be careful and cautious, hasn't he? So I think it will be a bit of a chess match, yeah.
So it sounds to me like you're probably picking AJ on points in a close competitive fight. Would that be about right?
I would say AJ on points, you know, to be honest with you. But the way he's fighting, the size of me, like I said, you know, was it David Chisori box usage, did he? I thought it looked very, very slow. Do you know what I mean? So I think AJ, you know, there's every chance that AJ could really shine in this, though, to be honest with you. But I mean, if you're asking me totally on my heart, I think, you know, it probably give AJ the edge. He could win a close points decision, but, you know, he could stand Usyk on his head. Do you know what I mean? But either way, I think I'd definitely go for AJ. But it's not without its dangers by far, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. When you were fighting Ricky, you were a really intense sort of guy. You walked through the ring, you could see you were intense when you got in the ring. You were feeding off that crowd energy. But, you know, it takes a certain person to be like that. How did you actually deal with fight week nerves yourself?
I always had, you know, incredible self-belief in myself. And that's what I do. You know, it's like me and Billy the last week, and certainly the last, you know, the day of the fight or the day of the weigh-in, we never even talked about the fight. We never even talked about tactics, because, you know, we said, listen, you've just got to do anything you can just to keep yourself cool, keep yourself focused. You know what I mean? We've got our game plan in our mind because we've been working on it the previous 12 weeks. You know what I mean? So the last 2 days on the way into the fight day until you get to the arena, whatever you can do to make you feel so you're most comfortable. And I would all build differently, you know. And the good thing is I've never been superstitious. So I just did what I pleased. If I wanted to get up and go for the walk, I'd go for the walk. If I wanted to just go in my games room and have a game of darts, I'd go and have a game of darts. If I wanted to have a kip, I'd have a kip, you know. And that was a bit of a... Because I know I'd hate to be superstitious, you know. If the fight day comes and you forgot to do something, it put your head away. But I was always very blessed, but ultimately I always had confidence. I always saw every fight as my shot window, if you like, you know what I mean. So and just huge self-belief in myself. I couldn't wait, you know. It wasn't pressure for me. I thought, I can't wait to, especially with me boxing on the television, I thought, I can't wait to go and showcase my talents, you know what I mean. I used to look so much forward to it. I always handled the nerves okay, yeah.
And I'll never forget the Ricky Fatten ring walk. I'll never forget that. It was just class. That'll go down.
You know that. Yeah. Well, you think of myself, you know, I've never been arrogant, but I've never been shy of confidence. And you think that was my next fight after the Floyd Mayweather fight. You know, I just had my first knockout defeat. What did I decide to do? Fight in front of 55,000 fans and come out with a fat suit. You know, that did tell you that, I'm cool before the fight. And I think most opponents, you know, there was never no expression on my face, wasn't there? And it must be very daunting for some opponents when they, you know, is he eyeballing me? Is he bothered? Is he nervous? Is he, you know, it's very hard because I was a little bit vacant, wasn't it? You know, and it must have been very scary for my opponents. But I always never struggled with my nerves. Never struggled with my nerves. I think it was just down to confidence, I guess.
Yeah, well, all the UK and Joshua fans are hoping he can hold his nerve on Saturday. As you say, it's going to be a great one and a great event, of course.
Well, don't forget, mate, you know, I mean, we want AJ to win because we all deep down we want to see the AJ and the Fury fight, don't we? And to be honest with you, you know, that's it's a banana skin for Tyson, isn't it? I think he will win. I think he will win his style. I think he's got in Deontay. I think he's planted a real message in Wilder's head. But that's a banana skin. That's no foregone conclusion. We all know Tyson is expected to go and walk through him again. But look what he did in that first fight. He stuck him on his ass. And that's the danger, isn't it? And I mean, the main thing is we want AJ to shine, you know, do us proud again. Win his fight, and Tyson obviously winning against Wilder, and then we've got the fight. I think the size of Joshua Fury fight will become even bigger then if he beats Wilder again and Joshua beats Usyk. It makes it even bigger. So, and heaven forbid if one of them was to get beat, we've lost our dream fight, haven't we? So it's a big night for in more ways than one, sadly, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely, Ricky. And you touch on such a good point there, because there's so much politics involved in boxing nowadays. You know, back in your era, you guys used to eventually end up fighting each other, or, you know, there was not too much calling out before it happened. I mean, do you think politics is going to stand in the way of us getting this fight? Or do you think we're actually going to get it when the fans want it before they're 40 years old?
I certainly hope not, but it always seems to be the case. But I just think, you know, I mean, you know, Eddie's the best in the business, isn't he, at the minute? You know, I mean, you've got Bob Arum involved and you've got these involved. But I mean, you've got the best people there in order to put the fight on. But I think they need to make it happen, because, I mean, they're all going to come under for some, you know, with some stick if they don't, because this is, you know, the biggest fight in British boxing history for me. It's an absolutely massive fight. It would be criminal for the sport in this country, which we're doing so well. We're producing so many good fighters and great champions. We've got the best heavyweights in the world. When it used to be America had all the heavyweights, now we've got them. And you know what? It's, and for our two best ones, you know, for them to maybe hang the gloves up and never fight each other, I think whoever's promoting it, or the TV companies, I think they've got to expect a bit of stick if it don't happen.
Yeah, definitely. We need to give them some stick if it don't happen, definitely.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Ricky, you know what? I know you're so busy today, so I really, really appreciate you jumping on with me here.
Pleasure.
Great to speak to you, as always. And I look forward to seeing you. We'll see you down there at the weigh-in and on fight night. And good luck to Campbell and yourself and Matthew.
No problem, Matthew. See you weekend, mate.
Take care, Ricky. See you, mate.
Cheers, pal. Bye-bye. See you, mate.
Cheers.